Welcome to ATCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today we are discussing about adult onset Still's disease. Still's disease is considered as a form of juvenile arthritis. It's chronic rheumatoid arthritis type disease, which has already got arthritis with spiking fevers and rashes all over the body. That is adult onset Still's disease, a type of arthritis looking like rheumatoid arthritis, and patient can have high degree fever along with rashes. It's an inflammatory disorder characterized by daily fever, arthritis and rashes all over the body. These rashes occurs when patient is having fever. The syndrome occurs mainly in adults. That's why it is called as adult onset Still's disease. This can also occur in younger children. Most adults are in their 20s and 30s. The etiology of adult onset Still's disease is unknown. Both genetic factors and variety of infectious triggers have been suggested. Most important thing what we have to remember is most of the time this adult onset Still's disease resembles like viral fevers. Patient can have high degree fever, rashes and joint pain. Sometimes this viral fever can be a trigger for adult onset Still's disease also. There is a criteria which is called as Yamaguchi criteria. We'll discuss about that. The criteria, Yamaguchi criteria, contains fever, that is daily fever, at least one per week, arthralgias or arthritis lasting 2 weeks or longer, a non-pruritic macular, maculopapular skin rash, that is salmon colored, that is very important. The color of the rash is very important, but this can be seen only in white skin person. Otherwise, it may become unnoticed, mainly on the trunk or extremities. It occurs during febrile episodes, and high degree leukocyte count, more than 10,000 WBC count can be seen in most of the patients. Minor criteria, most of the patients can have sore throat. That's why it resembles viral pharyngitis with viral fever. Patient can have lymphadenopathy. Infectious mononucleosis can have similar picture. They can have fever, lymphadenopathy, and when we give penicillins, they can have generalized maculopapular rashes also. Hepatosplenomegaly can be there. Abnormal LFT, elevated SGOT, SGPT, LDH, negative test for anti-nuclear antibody or rheumatoid factor may be there. So this type of patients, adult onset Still's disease patients, can present with high degree fever with rashes, and rashes disappears after once the fever subsides. Patient can also have joint pains and joint inflammation. The rashes are very classical. They are salmon colored rashes, maculopapular rashes that occur during febrile period. Rash mainly involves the trunk and extremities. There is a phenomenon called as Cobner's phenomenon. It can be seen in this type of patients. Cutaneous eruptions can be sometimes be elicited by stroking the skin. In that area, you can see these rashes. That's called as Cobner's phenomena. Histopathology may show non-specific findings, including dermal edema and mild perivascular inflammations. So these rashes are very classical, seen in adult onset Still's disease. Now, once we get a case like this, adult onset Still's disease, there are some markers of poor prognosis that we can see. Macrophage activation syndrome in adult onset Still's disease is very important. They have very bad prognosis. They can have pruritus, ARDS, pancytopenia, all these things. Other markers of poor prognosis are erosive polyarthritis during presentation of the disease is a poor prognosis. Involvement of shoulders or hip arthritis also poor prognosis. So patient who is having macrophage activation syndrome, erosive polyarthritis early itself, shoulder or hip joint involvement, all are poor prognosis in this type of patients. Now we can see what are the investigation can be done in this type of patients. The most important investigation is ferritin. We'll discuss that. But like any other arthritis, patient can have elevated ESR, elevated CRP, elevated WBC count, elevation in liver enzymes, SGOT, SGPT may be elevated in hundreds, but serum ferritin will be highly elevated, more than 300 nanogram per ml is classically seen in most of the adult onset Still's disease. So a patient who is having high degree fever, rashes which occurs during fever episode and joint pain, always remember to do serum ferritin. If it is in thousands, remember that that can be adult onset Still's disease. Whereas in viral fever, they can have similar finding, sore throat can be there, joint pain can be there, there will be elevated SGOT, SGPT, WBC can be slightly lower, ESR, CRP can be elevated, but serum ferritin will not be elevated like this. ANA and rheumatoid factor are present in less than 10% of the patients only. But in rheumatoid arthritis, ANA can be negative. Remember, ANA can be negative in rheumatoid arthritis. Rheumatoid factor can be positive in many patients who is having typical rheumatoid arthritis. Anti-cyclical citrullinated peptide is another investigation which can be done to rule out rheumatoid arthritis. Remember, patient can have rheumatoid arthritis like features, but they are all are not rheumatoid arthritis. So to rule out rheumatoid arthritis, we have to do anti-cyclical citrullinated peptide. Other investigations are ELISA test for hepatitis B and C, HIV virus should be done, because HIV can present same like this. Patient can acute HIV syndrome can present like fever, rashes, joint pain, all these things. So remember to do ELISA testing for hepatitis B, C and immunodeficiency virus. Other investigations are high levels of interleukin 6 is very important in all type of highly inflammatory condition, including macrophage activation syndrome. Interleukin 6 can be elevated and interleukin 18 can also be elevated. Then we have to see synovial fluid analysis if there is inflammation in the joint. Lymph node biopsy, bone marrow aspiration, all these things should be done to rule out lymphoproliferative malignancies. Skin rashes can be taken for skin biopsy. Dermal edema and mild perivascular inflammation in the superficial dermis can be seen in many patients. Immunofluorescence study of the skin biopsy may show slight deposition of complement compound in the blood vessels. So C3, C4 can be low in some of these patients because complement will be utilized here. So that levels can be low here. So the deposition of C3 will be seen on the blood vessel walls. Now we can see the treatment. It is same like any other immune mediated disease. Steroid or steroid sparing agents may be helpful here. So once the patient present with fever, rashes, joint pains, we can treat with paracetamol. If there is no renal failure, NSAIDs can be tried. If the patient is not improving with paracetamol or NSAID, we can start steroids. Prednisolone is the ideal drug. 1 milligram per kg body weight can be started as initial dosage. Once the patient improves, we can step down the therapy. Dose can be reduced slowly over weeks. If the patient is very sick, he is in ICU, he requires more intensive treatment, we have to start pulse dosage of methylprednisolone. 1 gram into 3 days can be started. So first day 1 gram, second day 1 gram, third day 1 gram methylprednisolone IV should be given. Then 1 to 2 milligram per kg body weight oral prednisolone can be started. Indications for a pulse therapy is life-threatening disease due to severe hepatic involvement, cardiac tamponade, disseminated intravascular coagulation and other systemic complication, we can start steroids. Anakinra is another recombinant human interleukin 1 receptor antagonist, can also be given. Tocilizumab can be given, it's interleukin 6 inhibitor factor. Other DMRs can be started once the patient is stabilized with steroids or and DMRs, other DMRs. After that we can start routine DMRs. Methotrexate can be started. Methotrexate dose is initial dose is 25 milligram per week with folic acid. Once the patient improves, we can reduce to 20 milligram, then 15 milligram, then 10 milligram, then 7.5 milligram. This should be given once in a week. Once per week methotrexate can be started. azathioprine can be started, cyclosporine, cyclophosphamide, hydroxychloroquine, leflunomide, sulfasalazine. All these drugs can be started according to standard protocol for rheumatoid arthritis treatment. Other drugs, they are TNF antagonist, mainly used in steroid or methotrexate resistant cases. Infliximab is one of the most important drug in this category. 3 mg per kg body weight at week 0, 2 and 6, then every 8 weeks thereafter. The dose may be increased up to 10 mg per kg per infusion, and then frequency may be increased to every 4 to 6 weeks. So these are the drugs which can be used to prevent TNF induced inflammation, so that can be started. So we have discussed one of the most important cause for fever with rash with joint pain in emergency room, that is adult onset Still's disease. There are various differential diagnoses for that, like common viral fevers, infectious mononucleosis, acute HIV syndrome. But remember, elevated serum ferritin may rule out all these conditions. Elevated serum ferritin is classically seen in adult onset Still's disease and macrophage activation syndrome. Thank you.